I think that even though that there was a lack of substances, but it almost still would have ended up with that, with her leaving with her friend, because it's like she was like so. She was like, "This is what I want. Like, I came here just for this sole reason to get her to drink." And I think everyone worked against it, and it was a really, really good job. But I feel like in the end, she might have just taken her and been like, "You know what? Like, we're going. Like, just come with me." And then, like, what to do in that situation? I don't know. I guess run after her, or drag her back, call to the PD and be like, "There's a fire." But it seemed like that, like, all roads were leading towards her taking her up. Anyway, so I was like, it was just something that I noticed. Yes.
One thing that I noticed with both scenes is that the main conflict, right, was coming from these BFF figures. Which then would make it very difficult for someone, like I was finding it very difficult to intervene in this scene whenever Julia got here, because I'm like, I could go up and say something, but I just know she's gonna be mean to me. and she said, very similar to her, right? Like I was like, oh, here, have my beer. Like I was trying to be helpful, yeah. And she was like, and so. I'm not gonna let that go. but it adds to it when the person that is doing the most oppressing is someone that you know is closer to that person than you are with that person, if that makes sense. So I was finding it really difficult to find tactics that would work. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
I found that like the ending of the scene was still kind of similar. There was still a lot of talking going on and nobody really listening to each other. And Lisa was still getting more and more stressed because instead of her like saying she needs to do the work and everyone trying to get her not to do it, it's her wanting to relax a little bit, but everybody's trying to get her to do it.
Yes. Yeah.
Oh. Go ahead.
The difference with this one was like during the first run through, I noticed Lisa was trying to resist herself a bunch, like saying, "No, I shouldn't do this. Like I've been having some trouble with this before. I don't want to go through that again. And like I have so much to do right now." But this time, there was still a little bit of "I have so much work to do," but there was less of the "I don't want to go through this again. I don't want to do that." It was more of a focus on "I have work to do." But in general, she just had less time to speak because it was more like Julia and everybody else were just like pulling her back and forth like a rope playing tug of war. And Elise was just kind of caught up in the middle of this. Just kind of, it felt a lot more chaotic than the other scenes.
Forgive me, I forgot your name, but I really liked your point about trying to get her to do something else. I think that's like, it's really valuable, and a lot of times as college students we see that, you know, the thing to do is to go to turn to these substances when you're stressed or whatever it may be, but there are so many healthy alternatives, and it's just about finding your own thing, and that's the one thing we did in our classes. We did mindfulness exercises and things like that to, you know, truly, like, we broke down and, like, tried to understand happiness and what that is, and I think that that's something that a lot of students don't, you know, you're not actively seeking to find, you're just looking for little things to, you know, get you through the weekend, get you through the day, get you through this test, whatever it may be. And there's a lot of power in encouraging your friends to find something that makes them happy and that's healthy for them. So, a great point, and thank you for that.
Yeah, sorry, earlier, like, I had forgotten really quickly, but the point that, like, in both situations, it was the main causing all of the conflict was the person's like closest friend. And going off of that point, that especially in college, a lot of people seem to be seeking like these short-term pleasures and like instead of like long-term like fulfillment and like feeling of satisfaction with yourself. I feel like since all of the people were the oppressor and like were the oppressor in the situation, were like the best friend. It's kind of I think it's an important thing for a bunch of people to realize, like, your are your friends toxic for your own health, for your own performance in Adderall.
And stuff goes bad, and we say don't call it TUPD, but there's that responsible friend act and whatnot, where you can call an RA or the police, and then any like no matter what's going on, and then you won't get in trouble if like something as serious as that happens. So don't think to not call for help.
Yes.
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 Take it with you, don't have it on your person, because that's how like kind of like the addiction like spurs. So then the same thing can go along with weed and alcohol. It's like don't have it in your room, don't have it on your person, because you'll be more likely to if you have it readily available. And then that's how they said that it wouldn't have gone as serious as their problem got if they didn't have it on them, if they didn't have it readily available.
And following on to what Esther said, a lot of this, like when we found in our interviews, a lot of the people that had, like, had experienced substance abuse, the thing that they told us, and the thing that I think many of us in the class agree, is that a lot of these substances, used in moderation, can be good, they can be fun, it can be nice to, you know, like, I know some people like my mom, she drinks a glass of wine sometimes, you know, and watches a movie, like that, you know, those are good things. And so a lot of the people that we interviewed, they told us, like, hey, like, just keep in mind that, you know, there's a difference between using a substance in a healthy way and maybe in a way that's enjoyable for everyone versus using substances in a way that's harmful and using it as a coping mechanism. And so they encouraged a lot of us to, or like when, even like when I was doing someone, he like encouraged me, even though, like, just because he was like, hey, like if you ever, like you're in that situation and you know someone, just make sure that you like, you know, make sure that they know why and why they're doing those things, and that the reason for using those substances is with good intent, not as, you know, difficult or something.
Yeah.
I think, like, if you want to intervene in a situation or stand up for yourself, you really have to, like, not be afraid to be unpopular, because that, if you're afraid to be unpopular, that's really going to hold you back. Like, if you need to stand up and yell at somebody, you know, like, and have a conflict with this one person, then that's, and that's what you need to do to protect somebody, then that's something that you should do.
Yeah?
I just wanted to say something on moderation, like how she said that someone, like suggestions were to help your friend moderate, but like for someone who's already in the phase of substance abuse, like sometimes moderation, like they've already gotten past that point, so like sometimes just limiting them isn't the best idea. Like that is a good idea for someone who's like just new into trying to figure out like how they use substances, but like for someone who's already past that, you have to do different kinds of things.
Yes.
Just just a little bit to answer your question about how some people cope with it. One of them said that like their relationship with God was actually a problem.
Mm-hmm. Their relationship
with God.
And if I may, for your point of like, for example, for Lisa, where she's kind of like gotten, she's moderation is not really a thing that they can do. A lot of it, from my opinion, is kind of moderate, and not moderation. Talking to someone you really trust, like she went to go, she started to be honest a little bit to the people that she was really close to, and then it was a healthy relationship, so they were like, okay, go see blah blah blah, like counselors on campus and everything, and kind of talk through it to kind of like figure out like more effective ways. So like professionals and using your resources, even if you're like past the point where moderation is an option, it can really, really help. So if and anyone you know could possibly kind of is in that stage, I would suggest doing that for them.
Yeah. Yeah. And I guess like as the saying goes, like the first step is admitting you have a problem or noticing a problem in your friends. And I actually do know a girl who went through something similar last semester, and all her friends like got her parents involved in things. So it's not like, don't think it has to be about you. Like you have to be the one person to like get them out of it. Yes, there's like other forms of help, there are counselors, and like getting parents involved sometimes is necessary. So yeah, everything that happens, it happens, and like don't keep it on yourself. Don't think that it's all on you, because there's so many people out there who